When it comes to writing, nobody's perfect. That's because we are all humans. That's where a second eye check can really help us. But we cannot always find somebody who can do that for us. In this video, we will see a detailed demo of how Grammarly works and what it has to offer us. Let's start. More than 1 billion people are studying English worldwide, and 1/4 of the world's population speaks at least some English. So it's important that what we write makes sense to others. With Grammarly, it's going to be a cakewalk when it comes to writing with confidence, and as it suggests, spelling errors, grammar checks like magic. It works on any website if you enable it. It comes in different flavors, browser extensions, web application, Microsoft Office add-in, or a native Windows desktop application. Let me show you a demo. This is the web application wherein you get that by app.grammarly.com. You can sign up using your email or Google account or your Facebook account, whichever you use. It gives you this page where you can either write directly or upload a document to proofread and correct your writing. So I'm going to just give a title here. So these are the options on the left hand side where I can just paste, upload, click on upload to click your uploaded document. Could be a text file. This is not a premium account. I'm just using a sample account to give you a demo of how it looks in the free version. So once we start typing here, so this is how it works. Clicking on these would correct it like magic. That's it. Once we start writing here, it's going to give us correction options and grammar checks done within the document. There is one advanced issue, as you can see here, which is a premium option. Clicking on that will give me a punctuation correction. But for now, let's stick to the basic version, and it is good enough for us to proceed further. So that was the web application. Now let's see how the MS Office add-in for Grammarly works. It is a great addition to your Word document and Outlook, so it can help while writing emails to your colleagues and bosses and avoid embarrassing mistakes in the email. The best part of Grammarly is not just checking grammar or spelling among other services, but it also helps you learn and improve your writing on the go, as it suggests options that we can learn in real time. First, download the add-in from here and install it. Grammarly for Microsoft Office. You can get the download here. After installing, you can see a new button under the Home tab, and also a new tab created within the Word document for Grammarly. It has toggle buttons that you can choose and select the specific writing issues you want Grammarly to check. There are 7 categories of checks you want to run on your document, but not all of these are available in the free version to get. For example, a plagiarism check, as I mentioned before, it's done with a premium account. There's also a settings option where you can choose if Grammarly needs to start up as soon as you open a Word document, and you can also view your account settings and check for updates and so on. Once you have chosen the required settings, all the correction suggestions will be neatly shown on the sidebar. Let me go ahead and enable Grammarly. So this is the sidebar that can give you correction suggestions, and here's where you can make the text corrections, just like the same way how we saw on the web application, with one simple click on the alert cards. These are all called cards, which can give you 4 options, like the one seen on the screen now. You could accept the correction suggestion by clicking on the green text, or click on learn more to get a detailed explanation of the highlighted writing issue and learn and improve your future writing, or add to dictionary, or simply ignore the alert. With the premium account, you also get more than 30 different document types that you can choose from this drop down over here, including a casual blog post. This way you can get the most accurate and relevant corrections for your specific writing situation. So that's how it works on a Word document, and in a similar fashion within your Outlook application as well. Once again, all these links are just a click away for you, conveniently provided in the description below. Just a note that this is an affiliate link which at no extra cost to you can give me a small kickback if you choose to use Grammarly. What's now left is the browser extension and the desktop application. Both of these work more or less the same way as we just saw. The browser extension, once installed, sits inside your browser and thus can help you write without errors on social media websites, like when you comment on Facebook posts, blog posts, write an email within your Gmail account or Yahoo account, and anywhere else on the internet. By popular request, Grammarly has even a Grammarly keyboard for mobile that can be used on Android and Apple phones. Although they aren't perfect yet, with some issues, they are nevertheless available and improving every single day. I highly recommend using the mobile versions as well. And here's where you can get the Grammarly for Windows, which is a native desktop application. Simply download, install, and start using it, and it works almost the same way how we saw on the web application. All said, there are a couple of extra benefits Grammarly offers, which is, number one, their blog, and the other one is their handbook. The handbook is available from their footer over here, handbook. I found that both the blog and the handbook go hand in hand. The handbook gives a lot of things to learn all in one page. The blog shows how and when to use certain punctuations, parts of speech appropriately. Here's what's given in the handbook, where we can learn the mechanics and techniques of writing, and some of the style options here: passive voice, singular, they,
parallelism, mixed constructions, and when to use a parenthesis, hyphen, ellipsis, dash, comma, colon, apostrophe, quotation marks. Let's see a sample of when and how to use quotation marks.
And there are some related options here: when to use the advice versus advice, what's the difference, American versus British quotation marks. It gives a very detailed study of how and when to use punctuation that we can learn from the handbook. Similarly, on blog posts as well, we have like this one, for example, what PS means and how to use it correctly in your email. And here's how to know the difference between Miss, Mrs. and Ms. and how to pronounce it. I could be pronouncing it incorrectly, but this article can help you with that, and some more useful blog posts. I hope you will use Grammarly, as there's no reason not to use, and above all, most of the options are free. So there's nothing that we have to wait for. To summarize, these are the services offered from Grammarly. It gives us plagiarism checking, grammar check, spelling check, punctuation, word choice, and style mistakes. And if you liked this video, please hit on that like button, subscribe to see more such videos, and don't forget to hit on the notification bell icon so you will be notified first as soon as there's a new video. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you again in my next video.